In this illustration, we'll discuss about the potential energy in an oblique collision. Here we are given that a ball moving in a straight line collides elastically with another stationary ball of same mass, such that at the moment of impact, the angle between the line passing through the ball's center is 45 degrees with the direction of initial motion of a striking ball. If balls are smooth, we are able to find maximum fraction of kinetic energy that transforms to potential energy in the process of collision. Here, to understand the situation better, we draw the picture where we are given that a ball is at rest and another identical ball is moving toward it, and when it strikes, here you can see the balls are identical, and at the point of collision, as this ball was at rest, it experiences an impulse in the direction along the line joining the two centers, and this ball starts moving in the direction of impulse. Say if it experiences an impulse J in this direction, so the other ball experiences an impulse J in opposite direction. And here we can see if this ball starts moving with a velocity V naught, then along the line of motion, we know well that at the point of maximum deformation between the two balls, both are moving with the same velocity V naught, and this ball, say it is also having a velocity V1 in the direction perpendicular to motion. And we consider the initial velocity is U, and we are given that this angle is 45 degree with the initial direction of motion. Now, in this case, here we can write that potential energy is maximum when deformation of balls is maximum. This implies along the line of impact, at this instant, balls will be moving at equal velocities. And here we can say it is V naught. And at this instant, first ball would also be having some component in normal direction also. So, here we can write by momentum conservation, in this situation, the momentum of the ball along the line of impact, if we conserve momentum along the line of impact, it gives you can see it is mu cos 45 degree will be equals to 2m V naught, as we have taken along the line of impact, both the balls would be moving at the velocity V naught at the point of maximum deformation, which gives us the value of V naught, which is equals to U by 2 root 2. Similarly, for a first ball in direction perpendicular to line of impact, here we can write mu sin 45 degree is equals to mv1, which gives us the value of v1, the component of first ball in the direction perpendicular to line of impact, this is equals to u by root 2. Now, in this situation, we can find out the maximum potential energy is the difference of initial kinetic energy minus kinetic energy final, which is considered to be the kinetic energy at the point of maximum deformation. So, as we already obtained the value of speeds, this can be given as initial kinetic energy. We know it is half mu square minus the kinetic energy at the time of maximum deformation for the two balls. For the second ball, it is only half m V naught square, plus for the first ball, it is half m V naught square plus V 1 square. If we substitute the values of V naught and V 1 over here, I'm leaving again the calculation part for you to simplify, and the final result we'll be getting here is 1/8 mu square. And if we calculate the fraction, we are required to find the maximum fraction of kinetic energy that transforms to potential energy. So this fraction can be written as this maximum potential energy divided by initial kinetic energy. So we can write it as 1/8 mu square/2 mu square, which gives us 1/4, that is the result of this problem.